हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई हैड आस्क्ड यू गाइस टू पोस्ट सम क्वेश्चंस जस्ट टू कीप थिंग्स इंटरेस्टिंग एंड आई हैव रिसीव्ड अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, 25 और 26 क्वेश्चंस, ऑफ विच अ फ्यू आर इररिलेवेंट विच इज टू बी एक्सपेक्टेड. सो आई विल स्टार्ट. ओके, आई विल स्टार्ट विद व्हाट आई कंसीडर टू बी अ जोक क्वेश्चन. कन्नन सेल्वराज सेज, विच इज बेटर, बीइंग सिंगल और बीइंग मैरिड? सो being unmarried in the Indian context is best for Ramachandran. I do not know about others. I hardly know about myself, but I feel being unmarried is the best option for a person like me with my personality. So that was a very easy question. Rio Raj, tips to improve our English and vocabulary. Okay, so first and foremost, Rio Raj, you have to go back and search my channel. I have posted a video specifically on this. But the short answer is, language doesn't mean anything. You can be dumb. You can be born with the ability to not speak and yet have excellent thoughts. So if you want to make your life interesting, it is better to develop your thoughts rather than the language. Once you have complex thoughts, you need to acquire the words to express those thoughts. Right? If you take a child, a 3-year-old child, the child will say, I'm hungry, I want to go to the bathroom, I'm sleepy, oh, I need this. The child needs only 10 words, correct? Or 15 words. Whereas a great philosopher needs probably 3,000 words to express what he feels. So what is more important is to develop the ability to think deeply. For that, you need to start thinking deeply. So once you have that ability to ask difficult questions, to probe yourself and to understand yourself and your environment, you will automatically develop the language skills. And English is just a language. If you can speak English well, doesn't mean that you are an intelligent person. But if you want to speak English well, I suggest that you start following the print media. Written English is much, these days it is awful. Everything has gone to the dogs. In those days, the Hindu and Indian Express used to be the gold standard. Indian Express more so. I like the Indian Express because it is more pro-India as compared to the Hindu. So, just start following the written media rather than the print media. TV. I don't own a TV. Okay, instead of the visual media is what I meant to say. So, stop watching TV and start reading things. But language in and of itself has no value. Thoughts have value. And if you have serious thoughts, you will acquire serious words. And if you still want to know more about it, just go search in my channel. Okay? Uday Mori has a very easy question. Please make Avial. Okay, I'll make Avial. Suresh asks, what is your perspective about death? Should we save for the future or splurge now? Death, in my opinion, is a very beautiful thing which gives meaning to life. Like how a full stop gives meaning to a sentence. If a sentence was just going non-stop, after a while we would stop reading it, it would stop making any sense. The fact that we have a limited time here makes our life all the more valuable to us. So if I knew that my life would never end, I would do nothing because I always have time. So death is a good thing. The problem with death is we don't know when it will happen. That is the problem that humans have. It is not death itself. And we always think we have time. This is the problem. This is the reason why most of us fear death. Because inherently we know that we may go tomorrow or now. Right now I could have a stroke and kill over right in front of you. Yet we make plans. So this is the contradiction we have, and we always have this fear, and this fear is what is mostly manifested as fear of death. Okay, so if you wholeheartedly embrace the fact that your time here is limited. Like in even Thirukural, Nerunal Ulan Urvan, Indrilayanum Perumai Udaithi Ulahu. It means that the grandiosity of this universe is the fact that you are here today and you may not be here tomorrow. He says that that is the grandiosity of, he doesn't say that is the misery of this universe. He says that is the greatness of this universe. Okay, and I think it is Buddha who said that the trouble is you think you have time. Okay, so death is a good thing. I don't want to be here forever. It's boring. So the next part of the question is, should we save for the future or splurge now? This question inherently assumes that money has some value. Money has no value for me. It has some residual value in the sense that I like to eat, I like to wear this t-shirt, because if I don't wear it, you will not look at me or people will not allow me to go buy food or something like that. But beyond that, beyond buying basic things like a pen, a paper or whatever, money in and of itself has no value, and splurging assumes that buying things is going to make you happy. I don't know what makes you happy. What makes me happy is definitely not getting things. I know that it makes me more miserable the more things I have. Okay. F.F. Varian, which diet do you follow? Okay. I already told you that I am not the expert to answer this. There are experts who have hundreds and thousands of videos. Google Dr. Jason Fung. Forget about diet. Control your insulin. If you want to lose weight, you have to control your insulin. If you want to learn more, Dr. Jason Fung. Just search him on YouTube. Okay. Ram Behra asks, which kind of people can I trust? The answer is very simple. You cannot trust anybody. You can't even trust yourself. You are not the same person you were yesterday. You cannot be rock solid yourself. How can you trust anybody? But having said that, that should not make you fearful of life. Whenever I say you, I mean myself. Okay, I'm just talking about myself. Even though I can't trust anybody, I still don't want to be fearful of life. I want to live my life, take risks, and tell people, trust people who I think are trustworthy. And then I may revise my judgment based on how they behave. But such iterative process is just a fact of life. So don't think too much about it. Just live your life. Flow info. He asks me a lot of questions. I think, I'll answer a few that are relevant. How to analyze a person? The first person and the only person whom I want to analyze is the one in the mirror. I don't even have enough time, knowledge, and the insight to know who I am. So I am least interested in analyzing anybody else. And I have a suspicion that everyone else is just as boring and just as messed up as I am. So I feel that once I know myself, I can easily know others. But my first order of business is to know who I am. And that may take a lifetime. And I'm pretty sure that it will be an incomplete work. So I am not interested in knowing others. So I cannot tell you how you can analyze others. I don't spend my time doing that. Ajit Jha asks me, what are my views on stoicism? Am I a stoic? Well, Ajit Jha, I'm sorry to say this, but I am not sure what stoicism is. I assume it's some kind of a label, where people are always calm. Okay? So I don't know whether there are any parameters by which you measure whether somebody qualifies as a stoic or not. But must be good. If you are peaceful, it is good. If you can maintain your calm, it must be good. I don't know whether I am a stoic or not. I'm pretty sure I am not, because I am prone to fluctuations in my emotions as well. Okay? So I'm sorry to give a very nebulous answer, but I have to be always honest. Okay? The next question is from Vinod Rajendran. He says, he is disappointed that I stray away from my core values for my channel, which is philosophy, because now I post cooking videos, exercise, how to do pull-ups and all that. And he says, one day I could be a guru with millions of followers. So Vinod Rajendran is assuming that I'm going to get some kick out of having millions of people following me. Already I have so much problems dealing with immature questions posted by few people with just 900 followers, 900 subscribers. Imagine how much headache I will have if I have millions of followers. So I have no joy in having many people appreciating me, okay? And I do not know what gives me joy, and I'm okay with it. I just do what makes me what I think makes me happy at this point of time, and if I find out that it does not make me happy, then I will try to do something else. So having millions of people, I am not here to achieve anything. There is nothing to achieve except for being peaceful. If you are peaceful, you have achieved everything. And I have not achieved that because I don't think I am as peaceful as I want to be. So I don't want millions of followers, Vinod Rajendran. Vivek Mohan says, how to stay mentally healthy and strong? This word strength itself is a very tricky word when it comes to mental strength. Mental strength is actually mental flexibility, the ability to accept reality as it is without any prejudice. So once you are able to accept anything, any outcome, okay, I wrote once that the ability to lose everything and still not lose your mind is the greatest superpower of all. The greatest superpower is not the ability to fly or shoot spider webs from your elbow or anything like that, or have a big hammer like Thor or whatever. The biggest superpower is equanimity, the ability to take good and bad as it comes without prejudice. And these are very simple words with which I have described what needs to be achieved, but it takes 10 lifetimes to achieve it, I assume, because I've just started climbing that mountain. And when I look up, it is a formidable task. But having said that, it is not about perfection. It is about progress. So if I am better today than I was yesterday, or even worse, that is okay. As long as I don't give up on myself, I think it is okay. So mental strength means the ability to absorb things without reacting to it, without allowing you to boil either with joy or with sorrow. Okay? So strength comes from your ability to maintain peace, and that comes from flexibility of mind, and that is another way of saying you have to be able to accept reality for what it is. Okay? Okay, we are at 12 minutes. Okay. Afro Samurai asks, what is your opinion about staying in the present moment all the time? Is there any way to control sexual desires? Okay, I don't know what is this thing about staying in the present moment. We all stay in the present moment. It is just that some of us are miserable staying in the present moment. I too am sometimes. Okay, and we need to work on it. There is nothing special about staying in the present moment. You know, whether we like it or not, we are all in the present moment. Some of us are bloody uncomfortable or bloody elated. Both of them are two sides of the same coin. So you are always in the same moment. Or in the present moment. Is there any way to control sexual desires? I do not know. Usually I do not control desires. I kill them. I try to kill them. If I feel that something is detrimental to me, I don't mess with it. I don't play with it. Okay? So I don't go about controlling anything. I just stop it. Okay? And no, I have not controlled my sexual desires. Kabil Gethin is asking me, did I follow intermittent fasting to lose weight? You know what? Just go and Google Dr. Jason Fung. Forget about me. I'm just some ant. There are mammoths who can help you with it. Flow Info is back again. How to overcome hunger while fasting? Okay. Again, go Google Dr. Jason Fung. It is called metabolic flexibility. See, I have not eaten now for 24 hours. I have no hunger, and the reason why I have no hunger is because my blood sugar is not falling, and the reason why my blood sugar is not falling is because my body is able to tap into my fat and convert it into energy. That is why I am not hungry. So you cannot be hungry, you cannot be miserable and do anything. You cannot achieve anything if you are uncomfortable. Okay? So for you to be comfortable, you have to train your body to tap into your fat. And if you start tapping into your fat, you will not be hungry. Okay? Vamsi Krishna, my experiences about intermittent fasting. My experiences are irrelevant. Try it for yourself and experience it yourself. So I won't waste time answering it. Anantu S. asks, how does one keep the desire burning? Initially, I made a video that if you want to achieve something, you have to keep your desire. Your desire must burn like the sun. You have to be miserable that you don't have that thing that you desire. He asks me how to keep it burning. I feel that there is no way to keep it burning. It has to burn on its own. It has to burn on its own so much so that even if you try to douse it, you should not be able to douse it. Only then you are assured of success. Or else, if Lady Luck smiles on you, you may be successful. Okay, Ryan Vijay asks, what is my view about the outbreak of COVID-19? Okay, I'm pretty disappointed. I had great plans for this year. Okay, and all of them are dead. All the plans are dead. But one good thing is, I got really fit. Right? Because of this COVID, I could concentrate on my pull-ups. I started doing more and more pull-ups. I can do 100 pull-ups today, 100 push-ups. So there is always a silver, or I would rather look at the silver lining than at the huge dark cloud. Okay? And I hope that sometime soon they come up with a vaccine or something and I can continue my normal life. I'm just hoping that that will happen. Okay? So, enna pommo? வந்தியாடி தங்கம் வந்து அங்கே வண்டி அங்கே வாழ்ந்து குட் கால் பொம்மா குட் கால் சரி இப்படி வந்து படுத்து ஓகே என்ன பொம்மா இங்கே வா இங்கே வாடி கொண்ணு ஸோ பொம்மி ஹேஸ் கம் ஹியர் டு சே ஹலோ டு ஹாய் பொம்மு என்னம்மா ஓகே பர்மா குமார் ஆஸ்க்ஸ் டு ஐ ஸ்டில் ஒர்க் ஆம் ஐ ஃபைனான்ஷியலி இண்டிபெண்ட் ஓகே எஸ் ஐ ஒர்க் அண்ட் ஐ டு நாட் நோ வெதர் ஐ எம் ஃபைனான்ஷியலி இண்டிபெண்ட் ஐ வில் நாட் நோ இட் டில் த டே ஐ கோ ப்ரோக் So it depends on what is going to happen to me and how I'm going to spend. But money, I think, is overrated. This is my opinion. Okay, everything here is my opinion. Don't follow anything I say. Don't follow anything I say. Please do not. I don't know anything. Okay? Okay. Karthikeyan Rajendran asks me, you seem to be a rational person. Why did you not adopt street dogs? Okay? Karthikeyan Rajendran is making the wrong assumption that I am living my life for the benefit of others, be it dogs or humans. I am here to amuse myself first. If I am not happy, I can't make anyone happy. So I am not into sacrificing myself and all that. Okay, I did some things for my elders to make sure that I took care of them and all that. But once that duty... So once those duties are over, I want to concentrate on myself. So, yeah, I am not here to do good to the world. I am here to do good to myself. And if it so happens that someone benefits from it, then so be it. And I do not want to harm anybody in the process of doing good for me, as defined by the laws. Okay? So, I strictly look at what is good and what is bad based on legality. I do not subscribe to morality because morality is... It is very fluid. Morality is not fixed. Even within myself, what I think of as moral now, tomorrow I'll think of it as amoral and vice versa. Okay? So Prithiviraj asks, have you ever regretted not being with a woman and not having a family? If you did, how did you deal with it? Yes, I regret it daily. Just like how I regret not being able to eat ice cream. But I regret being obese 100 times more. So the consequences of not having that pleasure are far worse than just having that temporary pleasure. This is again my opinion based on my choice. Okay? So yes, I regret it daily. I wish ice cream made me thinner. I wish not working out made me leaner. But that is not reality. I have to go with reality. And all my choices have consequences. And I have learned after so many failures that I can't go for the short-term pleasure. I can't go for the instant gratification, because afterwards I am miserable for a long time. Dilip Kumar asks, I fail at one meal a day plan, how to improve willpower? Okay, Dilip Kumar, willpower is just an illusion. There is no willpower. Unless you are comfortable, you cannot do it. The reason why you are hungry is because you are not metabolically flexible, and the reason why you are not metabolically flexible is because you have not trained your body. Like, you know, if you cannot do pull-ups, I can't ask you to do 10 pull-ups now and then blame you for it. It's not like your willpower or something. You just don't have the training. And just Google Dr. Jason Fung, Google metabolic flexibility, how to go into ketosis and all this, okay? There are people who are 5 million times more qualified than me to answer this. Rizu Banerjee asks, okay, he sent me a very kind message, a very long message, and I appreciate his message because he didn't use any GR8, UR and all that. He had taken the time to type out the full word, so thank you so much. And he asks me basically, can I suggest some books? Okay, Rizu, I'm going to be very disappointing here. I don't read books. I read only very small books because my ability to remember, especially non-fiction books, I don't read. I have read a few non-fiction books, The Rise and Fall of the Third Chimpanzee, Phantoms in the Brain, India's Nuclear Bomb by Raj Chengappa. It's a very good book. You should read it. Wings of Fire by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. I have read only a handful. Okay, I read Dilbert and funny books like that, but I've read a lot of books by Dave Barry. Okay, I like funny books, but I don't like serious books, and I definitely cannot read big books because by the time I am in the 10th page, I've already forgotten what happened in the first page. Okay? Richard Joseph asks, how to stop thinking about other person's opinions of us? Okay? This problem usually comes when you don't know about your own self. This is the first stage of the problem. Okay, I know that I am an intelligent person. And I say that with neither pride nor prejudice. It is just a matter of fact. I am a hard-working person. I am also an obese person. I am also an average-looking person. Okay, if someone tells me, hey Ram, you're handsome, it doesn't float my boat this way or that way because I can assess myself. So if you can assess yourself, you don't look towards others to assess you. This is stage one of the problem. There is another type of problem where you know you're rotten and you want others to tell you sweet lies. So these kind of people also seek the opinion of others. And this comes from the inability to accept that it is okay to be rotten. It takes all kinds of people to make this world go around. You don't have to be perfect. Just be who you are, and if you don't like who you are, try to change it without beating yourself up at this moment of time. That is all. Once you have this, you don't look towards others for approval. This is why, you know, I am rude and all that. It sounds really horrible when I say I don't care about what you think about me, but this is the truth. I really don't care about what you think about me because I know who I am myself, and unless there is a huge revelation that I am wrong, I will continue to believe that I know about myself. Okay? Tannai ariya tanakkoru kedillai, tannai ariyamal thane kedugindrar. Tannai ariyum arivai arindapin tannaiye archithu thaan irundare. Thirumular says that once you know yourself, you don't need anybody else. You don't even need God. Okay? So you know yourself. That is the most important journey. Okay. Sanjay Mishra asks, how did you manage building a frugal house? Hey, just do it. Don't worry about others. Don't worry about what others think about you. Just do what you want. Life is short. Soon, okay, if you worry about anything, just remember this. Pretty soon you'll be dead. Once you think about this, everything becomes irrelevant. Everything becomes a game. Okay? Arakkar Arasan asks, I am 20 years younger than you. I identify with you. What would you advise me? The biggest advice I would give to anybody is to not seek or take any advice. I don't know anything. I hardly know about myself. How can I give you advice? First, go with your own experiences. விதிவழியே சென்று வேந்தனை நாடுமின் அது இது நெஞ்சில் அகல்கின்றவாறு. அகேன் ஐ கோ டு திருமூலர். ஓகே, பை த வே, ஐ எம் நாட் அ ரிலிஜியஸ் பர்சன், பட் ஐ லைக் த ஓல்ட் விஸ்டம். ஓகே, இட் மீன்ஸ் தட் ஜஸ்ட் கோ வித் யுவர் ஃப்ளோ, டோன்ட் ஆஸ்க் அதர்ஸ். மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் த பீப்புள் ஹூ கிளைம் டு நோ டோன்ட் நோ எனி திங். ஈவன் யுவர் ஓன் பேரண்ட்ஸ், மை ஓன் பேரண்ட்ஸ், தே டோல்ட் மீ தட் தே நியூ வாட் இஸ் குட் ஃபார் மீ, பட் தே தெம்செல்ஸ் வேர் மிசரபிள். யூ நோ, தே வாண்டட் to fight for money, they wanted to have conflicts in the family. My own parents, my own uncle, my own grandmother, my own aunt, everyone, and they claimed that they knew better. No one knows anything. An honest person will say, hey, you know what, I'm fumbling through life and these are my experiences. I will narrate my experiences to you, see if it makes any sense and if it delivers any value to you. This is the best advice one can give. So, Arakar Arasan, go with your own experiences, and I can guarantee you that you will make 100 mistakes in life, and at least you can own up to your mistakes because they were mistakes that you made out of your own decision. Okay? We become miserable when we follow others' advice and we make mistakes and when things don't turn out, and then we blame others and we blame ourselves. At least here, we have only ourselves to blame and we can kind of omit the other person. Okay? So, I hope this was of some use to you. We'll keep doing it. I hope you will keep the questions relevant. I am not a diet expert, so I can't answer too many questions on dieting and all that. Insulin control is where it is at. Google Dr. Jason Fung. This is the generic answer to all the dieting questions. Okay? Thank you.